As of February 2021, official California Department of Corrections and Rehabilitation CDCR records show 707 inmates on California's death row, the lowest it has been since 2011. Primarily due to suicide, death from other causes, and resentencings by newly elected progressive district attorneys. 23 of those on death row are women, held at the female death row in the Central California Women's Facility. In Chowchilla, the first known death sentence in California was recorded in 1778. On April 6, 1778, four Cumae chiefs from a Mission San Diego area rancheria were convicted of conspiring to kill Christians and were sentenced to death by Jose Francisco Ortega. Commandant of the Presidio of San Diego, the four were to be shot on April 11th. However, there is some doubt whether the executions actually took place. Four methods have been used historically for executions. Until slightly before California was admitted into the Union, executions were carried out by firing squad. Upon admission, the state adopted hanging as the method of choice. The penal code was modified on February 14, 1872. To state that hangings were to take place inside the confines of the county jail or other private places. The only people allowed to be present were the county sheriff, a physician, and the county district attorney, who would in addition select at least 12 reputable citizens. No more than 2 ministers of the gospel and no more than 5 people selected by the condemned could also be present. Executions were moved to the state level in 1889 when the law was updated so that hangings would occur in one of the state prisons, San Quentin State Prison and Folsom State Prison. According to the California Department of Corrections, although the law did not require the trial judge to choose a specific prison, it was customary for recidivists to be sent to Folsom. Under these new laws, the first execution at San Quentin was Jose Gabriel on March 3, 1893, for murder. The first hanging at Folsom was Chin Hayne, also for murder, on December 13, 1895. A total of 215 inmates were hanged at San Quentin and a total of 92 were hanged at Folsom. California adopted the gas chamber as its sole method in 1937. The first people to die in the San Quentin gas chamber were Albert Kessel and Robert Lee Cannon on December 2, 1938. 3 more people had their death sentences carried out within 2 weeks. Up until 1967. 194 people were executed by lethal gas, including 4 women. The last person that was executed in the state of California was Clarence Ray Allen. Clarence Allen was born on January 16, 1930. He was an American criminal who was executed in 2006 at the age of 76 by lethal injection at San Quentin State Prison in California for the murders of 3 people. Allen was the 2nd oldest inmate at the time to be executed in the United States since 1976. In 1974, Allen plotted the burglary of France Market, a Fresno area supermarket owned by Ray and Franchly Tuitz, whom Allen had known for years. The plot involved his son, Roger Allen, as well as Ed Savala, Carl Mayfield, and Charles Jones. Mayfield and Jones worked for Allen in his security guard business as well as part of a burglary enterprise allegedly operated by Allen. Allen arranged for someone to steal a set of door and alarm keys from the market owner's son, Brian Schlietuitz, while Schlietuitz was swimming in Allen's pool. Allen then arranged a date between Schlietuitz and Mary Sue Kitts for the evening, during which time the burglary took place. The burglary netted $500 in cash and $10,000 in money orders from the store's safe. Following the commission of the burglary, Kitts told Brian Schlietuitz that Allen had committed the crime, which she knew as she had helped Allen cash money orders that had been stolen from the store. Schlietuitz confronted Roger Allen and informed him that he had been told of the crime by Kitts. Roger Allen told his father, Clarence, who said that Schlietuitz and Kitts would have to be dealt with. He enlisted three employees of his security firm, Charles Jones, Carl Mayfield and Eugene Lee Furrow. Allen called a meeting at his house and told Jones, Mayfield, and Furrow that Kitts had been talking too much and should be killed. Allen called for a vote on the issue of Kitts' execution. The vote was unanimous because those present feared what would happen if they did not go along with Allen's plan. Allen had previously told his criminal accomplices that he would kill snitches and that he had friends and connections to do the job for him even if he were in prison. He had also referred to himself as a mafia hitman and stated that the secret witness program was useless because a good lawyer could always discover an informant's name and address. Allen kept a newspaper article about the murder of a man and woman in Nevada, and claimed he had blown them in half with a shotgun. Allen ordered Lee Furrow to murder Kitts. After an unsuccessful attempt to poison her with cyanide capsules, Allen called Furrow to learn if he had killed Kitts. Furrow told Allen he was in the process of strangling her and Allen replied, "Do it." After killing Kitts, Furrow threw her body into the Free and Kern Canal. The body has never been found. Years later, Furrow was arrested and confessed to the murder, implicating Allen. Allen was tried for first-degree murder, convicted and received a life sentence. Furrow, who said Clarence threatened to kill him as well if he didn't murder Mary, pleaded guilty to a reduced charge of second-degree murder. Allen conspired with fellow inmate Billy Ray Hamilton while in Folsom Prison to murder the various witnesses who had testified against him, including Brian Schlietuitz. Allen intended to obtain a new trial where there would be no witnesses to testify to his acts. After Hamilton was paroled from Folsom Prison, he carried out Allen's orders. On September 5, 1980, Hamilton and his girlfriend, Connie Barbo, went to Friends Market while Brian Schlietuitz, who testified against Allen, was working. There, Hamilton murdered Schlietuitz and fellow employees Josephine Roca, 17, and Douglas White, 18, with a sawed-off shotgun and wounded two other people, Joe Rios and Jack Abbott. Rios raised his arm as Hamilton fired on him and this action undoubtedly saved his life. The other wounded survivor, Abbott, was a neighbor who heard the shotgun blasts, came to the market to investigate, and was also shot by Hamilton. Abbott returned fire and wounded Hamilton, who escaped from the scene. 5 days after the events at France Market, Hamilton was arrested while attempting to rob a liquor store. On his person was found a hit list with the names and addresses of the witnesses who testified against Allen at his trial for Kitts' murder. Brian Schlietuitz was on the list. A jury convicted Hamilton of 3 counts of murder, 1 count of attempted robbery, and 2 counts of assault with a deadly weapon. As special circumstances making Hamilton eligible for the death penalty, the jury found that Hamilton had committed murder, robbery, and multiple murders predicated on the killing of other victims. The jury returned a unanimous verdict of death, and the Contra Costa County Superior Court sentenced Hamilton on March 2, 1981. As special circumstances making Allen eligible for the death penalty, the jury also found that Allen had previously been convicted of murder, had committed multiple murders, and had murdered witnesses in retaliation for their prior testimony and to prevent future testimony. During a 7-day penalty phase, the Attorney General introduced evidence of Allen's career orchestrating violent robberies in the Central Valley, including 10 violent crimes and 6 prior felony convictions. Allen was convicted of 3 counts of first-degree murder with special circumstances and was received on to California's death row at San Quentin State Prison on December 2, 1982. Allen was executed by lethal injection on January 17, 2006, the day after his 76th birthday, at California's San Quentin State Prison. He became the second oldest inmate to be executed in the United States since 1976. He was the most recently executed inmate in California as of March 2019, when the imposition of the death penalty was suspended in the state by Governor Gavin Newsom. Allen was assisted in the death chamber by 4 correctional officers, though a media observer stated that he was clearly moving under his own power. To the surprise of everyone present, the warden indicated that he needed an additional injection of the lethal potassium in order to stop his surprisingly healthy heart. Allen wrote in his final statement, which Warden Stephen Ornowski read immediately following the execution, "My last words will be haka hey, it's a good day to die. Thank you very much. I love you all. Goodbye." Allen died with an eagle feather on his chest. He was wearing a medicine bag around his neck and a beaded headband. He was visited shortly before the execution by 2 Native American spiritual advisors. Allen died at 12:38 a.m. Approximately 250 death penalty opponents gathered for a candlelight vigil outside the walls of San Quentin. His last meal consisted of buffalo steak and free bread, as well as a bucket of KFC white meat only chicken, sugar-free pecan pie, sugar-free walnut ice cream, and whole milk. Thank you for watching Death Row.